as a possible career.
Since about 06, I discovered that I like being in the camera and the spotlight in a good positive note.
Right. So that's not the only project you have that you're working on. And due to some disclosure disclaimers, we have to be very careful about what we say about your project in Georgia.
Yes. I can say that I play a very dead person at times down there. One of the casting companies knew someone, and they said, well, you know, we'd like to give this guy a chance, you know, and I'm actually a background extra.
Does your T-shirt indicate...
Yeah.
Is that what you're pointing? Because I heard I've never watched this series.
I know, right? Like, if you can, on Ustream, if you can see his T-shirt, like, apparently this indicates a little bit of the top secret that we're not allowed to release.
Yes.
We do know. Can we tease it?
I'm actually under a very strict non-disclosure
policy. Okay. So we can't even tease it.
All right.
Okay. But he is dead, up walking around in the background there. Okay.
But that excites me. It sounds like some real doors and opportunities are opening for you. Is this something you want to continue?
Absolutely. I enjoy doing it, and it's a whole world to itself. Once you get in the door and get past what your perception of people and actors and things are, it's just like a big community. You know, it's kind of like with you guys being in broadcasting. You know, right. If you hear this broadcaster in Brandenburg, you know, mm-hmm. and you're like, well, you know, I'd like to meet that person, and you all can converse and talk about, you know, soundboards, engineering things.
Yeah, the same
things.
Lingo, right.
Right. I mean, you're kind of welcomed into that group. Well, I have actually got to the point where I've been welcomed into that group, and I've made a lot of friends.
So what are they really like, the really famous people?
Well, the funniest thing I found out, I made good friends with Tim from Moonshiners.
Okay.
Tim Smith, he's fire chief in Climax, Virginia. Him and his wife, Shelby, and his boy, JT, and their famous buddy, Steve Tickle. He seems to be the babe magnet up there. If he can stay sober long enough. Sorry, Steve.
And then there's that.
Yeah. He drinks a little bit too much moonshine. But anyway, most of the people that you meet, once they, you know, they don't have that... you know, this is a stalker fan fear of you once they welcome you into the community. These people, you know, they're just like everybody else. They put their clothes on every morning and go to work and come home and kick their shoes off and watch the news like everybody else. It's the most shocking thing to me about it. You know, you would figure you kind of put this perception of these people up and make them bigger than what they are.
Yeah.
They're just everyday people that, you know, right. doing a job.
Right.
Yeah.
They got into it the same way you did.
Yeah.
Auditions and begging and pleading. And
have you become starstruck from when you've met anyone?
Well, I got to meet Reba McEntire. She's, you know,
I
adorable Reba. And sweet as she can be. I met her on the steam plant road down in Gallatin, Tennessee. That was through a friend of mine. She has a big horse farm down there right off the main thoroughfare there next to the bridge. Got to meet her through a friend just momentarily. You know, like I say, I've made friends with a lot of people in music. The guys, you know, like I say, there's a little circle there. Once you're kind of known as being somebody that's a...
trustworthy.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. Not the stalker type fan, right. You know. More people welcome you and
can you get me in that circle?
Yeah, so what do we do to get in the circle? Like, I want to be in the circle.
You're media, you have a pass, you know.
If I'd known it was that easy
time. But then we get treated a little bit like media, too. It's like, yeah. Oop, we got to be real careful about mm-hmm. what we say or do because they're afraid that we're going to expose them. And, well, we do.
That's silly
what,
jobs.
That's what I know. That's
what
tabloid media does.
I said, don't expose me because my non-disclosure agreement on that show will cost me dearly.
We wouldn't dare. Absolutely. That's off the record. We're so excited about the things that you've got going on. So are you still in Big Clifty? Do you plan on staying in Big Clifty?
Actually, I live in Brownsville now.
Okay.
Oh, you've moved on down the road.
Already moved.
We've already lost
him.
Yes. I'm still a Grayson County Cougar at heart, believe me.
There you
I
go.
Get, I get
you Wildcats heard it here.
I have a Grayson County Cougar shirt I wear adamantly. Anytime
so you're the
a
Cougar fan
on.
That sits among the blue and white over there that we can't
yes.
figure out who it is.
And
thank
usually,
you.
Usually black and blue by the time I make it out of the gym, but no.
We'll take it.
I'm Grayson okay. County proud.
But you are still close here, and you're in Kentucky, and
yes.
you've not moved to the big city of Nashville or Georgia
no.
or anywhere. So you're how many days a month are you spending acting?
Well, right now we're kind of in a off-season sort of thing going mm-hmm. on. There's a lot of pre-production going on, meetings of the big wheels and whatnot, financiers and all that kind of stuff. So, and there's a lot of the writers and things that are still fine-tuning scripts and things.
When will Patsy be released? Do we have a release date for that?
We don't right now because there are just so many. We have financiers and actors from, you know, I'm the only person that's been picked in the show from Kentucky whatsoever. Mm-hmm. We have several from Arkansas. Matter of fact, several of the actors have been on local radio stations and whatnot, like mm-hmm. we're doing here in Arkansas. I've seen that on there on YouTube. But they're from all over. There's some people from England. There's several ladies from France. They're actually involved in the movie. Just basically Patsy Cline fans from all over the world. The trick to the movie is the first, I would say, 20% of the movie is about the historical Patsy Cline. From that point forward after the crash, it transitions and becomes a movie about the talent search for a woman to portray Patsy Cline in a movie.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of outside the box sort of thing. Okay. John Russell's come up with. All these women are coming to Nashville, mm-hmm. which technically is Mobile. But they're all coming to Nashville and competing and fighting and clawing as honorable
I don't believe
ladies
women
do.
Ever did. We
no.
never do that, Tim. That's not yeah. true.
I just want to say, I
such a stereotype of us girls.
It's kind of funny that they're paying you to actually be a bodyguard and then to turn around and act like you're playing a body, you know, to act
right.
as a bodyguard. Do they know? I mean, they could just film you, right? Doing your daily job.
Do your daily job.
On set.
It's a two for one.
Producer John Russell sent an email out to everybody the other day. It says, you know, before he actually chose to hire me for bodyguard, I thought it was kind of comical. He actually sent an email out. I think I'll have to hire Tim for my actual bodyguard, and they wind up doing
they
it.
Ended
Tim,
up
his
doing
production
that.
Assistant did. So.
That's awesome. When you're found trustworthy, I guess it's hard to find people you can really trust, and when you do, you adapt them to as many roles as they're willing to let you adapt them to. It's so awesome to get to meet you today and have you on and people to hear your story, because when people do good things in the county or neat things that are kind of once in a lifetime, that's what the show's for. We want to spotlight those people. We know that you're working with a local lady for all of your photography. When you get to a celebrity status, you could go out and choose anybody probably you wanted, but you've chosen to go ahead and work with people that you know and trust yourself. And there's a local lady doing your photography.
Yes, that's Miss Valina Miller of Valina Lynn Photography. I've known her since high school, and she is a very, very capable photographer. I absolutely love her work. There's a lot of it she posts on Facebook. She's an excellent photographer, and she's going to be the one handling all my press releases and photos and stuff.
And you have a manager local who is working for you.
My manager that I actually had over my acting stuff is we've actually transitioned. They
okay.
had a bigger gig come along per se. So I'm actually without a manager at the moment, but we're gonna.
Now we know what we're gonna
now
do.
We're,
after
so
the
now
show.
We're seeking a manager. I think I could take on another job. Hold on, I may be able to help you. It's been so nice to meet you and have you in this morning, and best of luck to you.
Okay.
And we look forward to seeing Patsy come out.
I would like to give a shout-out real quick to my good friend Eric Wesley Small, E. Wesley Small, one of the greatest guitarists out here in Grayson County. We're trying to get him a studio musician position on the film set where he's actually up there, you know, playing on one of the background bands.
Very nice.
And stuff.
That would be awesome.
I've
heard Eric play guitar. He's really, really
well,
amazing.
I'll tell you what, E. Wesley Small, when you're cast, you can take the chair that Tim's in today and bring your guitar. We would love to hear
Perfect.
That.
We love live music.
He is absolutely one of the best guitarists I've heard literally in the United States. He's phenomenal.
Wow, fantastic. Be awesome to hear you, Eric, on air one day. We have to get to a break, but it's been so nice, Tim, for you to come in and let our audience know about the awesome things going on in your life. And we're just very proud of you as a hometown guy that you've taken the leap and you've done some awesome things. So best of luck to you.
Well, thank you.
You're very welcome. Stay with us after this. We have our Pet of the Week segment coming up. I'm Misty Thomas. We'll be back within the know just after this.
How do you like me now? Then you married in the money, girl.